Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Dr. Vladimir Salgado, for your kind invitation. Presbyopia is sometimes the first sign of aging. The eyes fade too short and light too dim to read. And at that point, we seek help to manage the tasks we must do at short distance because we can't see enough well to perform them properly. Whatever we do, we stay older every day, and we only can mitigate signs and symptoms of aging, but we cannot stop aging. So, age is a natural and unavoidable condition of the human being, and must be addressed this way. Here I am, less than 1 year old, 10 years old, 30, and 60 years old, now perspective, of course. As the body ages, the same happens with the crystalline lens. The structure of a young crystalline lens is different from the older crystalline lens. Despite any electrical stimulation of the ciliary body, or any drops, those for instance are good for everything, or others more specific, the crystalline lens is staying older. The main principle of medicine is primum non nocere, and to mitigate a sign or a symptom of aging, we must be very careful in what we are going to do to the patient. And so, for those reasons, I am very conservative in the approach, in the surgical approach of presbyopia. I also have another principle. That is, if possible, we must correct the problem where it lies. And presbyopia is mainly a problem on the crystalline lens, and so must be addressed on the crystalline lens, if possible. When we are going to perform a surgical procedure in the eye of a patient to correct presbyopia, we must analyze several parameters to do the best procedure for that specific patient. And we must know very well what we are going to make the patient gain and lose with the procedure. And the gain must be much, much, much bigger than what we lose, because we always value much more what we lose than what we gain in, of course, with opposite signs. And there is no surgical procedure in which the patient potentially loses zero. As I used to say, there are no free lunches. So, to correct presbyopia, I recommend the patient to use glasses, as I do, if you don't want glasses, contact lenses. If the patient is anatropic or hyperopic, bifocal contact lenses. If he is myopic, bifocal contact lenses or monofocal contact lenses with mini monovision, under correcting the non-dominant eye between minus 0.5 to minus 1.5 diopters. If none of those solutions are good for the patient, is now that I give the third step, that is surgical. And to make a surgical procedure in the eye of a patient to correct presbyopia, there are some main questions, and those for me are the most important. Is the patient anatropic, hyperopic, or myopic? How old is the patient? Both eyes have potentially good sight. Are both eyes healthy? What are the worry and the hopes of the patient? And what is the psychological profile of the patient? An easygoing or a perfectionist? According with the age of the patient and the refractive status of the eyes, and those are my general rules, of course, sometimes I change according with the other parameters, but in a general manner, in hematropic patients on the 40s, I don't operate them. On the 50s, I hesitate and I prefer not to operate them. But if the patient accepts to lose some quality of vision, I do a clear lens extraction and implant in a trifocal IOL. And the same on the 60s. In hyperopic patients on the 40s, if the patient is used to wear glasses or contact lenses, I think it's better doing nothing because the patient is used to see very well for far, and with any procedure we do on that eye, he will see less than before. If the patient is not used to wear glasses or contact lenses, so I think a clear lens extraction with trifocal IOL is my procedure of choice. On the 50s, the same. And it's better if the patient is not used to wear glasses or contact lenses, is used to impact for far. On the 60s or more, okay, this is my main indication for clear lens extraction with trifocal IOLs. In myopic patients on the 40s, if LASIK or PRK are possible, okay, so minimal vision is my preferred intervention. Let in the eye, non-dominant eye, minus 1 to minus 1.5 diopters. If LASIK or PRK are not possible, then phakic IOLs with minimal monovision. On the 50s, in some patients, maybe LASIK is still a good procedure. Or I prefer, if the patient has good, best, correct visual acuity, then I recommend clear lens extraction with trifocal IOLs. If his best correct visual acuity is between 0.5 and 0.8, clear lens extraction with monofocal and mini monovision. If the best correct visual acuity is less than 0.5, this patient, I operate him then with monofocal IOL and dark final refraction for about minus 1.5 to minus 2 diopters. On the 60s, the same as in the 50s, except I think there is no more room for LASIK on the 60s. 10 years ago, I was a believer in accommodation, in accommodating IOLs, and I implanted a lot of crystal lens. This lens was somewhat difficult to implant, but okay. I have these results, and we have in dark pink is the monocular results, and in light pink the binocular. And we see in the first graphic the visual acuity for far, monocular and binocular here, about 40% of patients had 20/20, and 20/40 almost 100%. The second graphic is the visual acuity for intermediate vision without correction. This was really very good result for intermediate vision. And for here, only 20% in monocular and 40% in binocular at J1, and J5 in 92%. I operated my mother-in-law 10 years ago, and she stays very happy because she had no more to use glasses. Minus 1 in the right eye, minus 0.5 in the second, in the left eye. 0.9 for far without correction, and 1.0 with far correction. On the left eye, 0.7 for far without, and 0.9 with far correction. J1 plus without any correction. And 20/20 with or far correction or without correction for intermediate, and J1 with far correction for near. And 10 years after, we can see her with dim light reading small prints. But that was not for everybody, and we could not warrant the patient that we would see very well for near. And so now my procedure of choice is implanting the trifocal, the fine vision IOL that I do without using viscoelastic. As we can see here, the capsular axis, I perform it with a side-borne irrigation that is good enough to make the hybrid dissection. Then enlarging the incision to 2.0 millimeters. The fake emulsification is very easy to do, but we must be very, very careful in polishing the anterior and posterior capsule. The loading of the IOL, we must be very careful in not to let the haptics trap on the cartridge because they can break. And the implantation of the IOL also with the side port irrigation. So we have no viscoelastic that pushes the lens or decenter the lens. And I have very good results with this. Even relaxing incisions can be made with this technique. Now I have here the photos of the lens, the trifocal IOLs we have in the market. And we can see that the designs are very different. And we must be very careful in some designs of IOLs because they do not fit all bags and some decenter. And a case like this is a tragedy for the patient. And thank you for your attention.